Hello everyone, I'm thrilled to share my research, titled Generation of Upright Panoramic Image from Non-Upright Panoramic Image at WACV 2024. I'll be covering four aspects in my representation of this research: introduction, related research, proposed approach, and experiments. Panoramic cameras can capture upright panoramic images, but tilting the camera leaves non-upright images with rotational distortions on the spherical surface and warped projections on the plane. Our research addresses this challenge with the goal of achieving high-quality image generation in a more efficient manner. Unlike previous approach, then predict tilt angles first, and then adjust the image through resampling. We propose a novel pixel-level mapping method that integrates angle prediction and resampling into a single process for image adjustment. Our method achieves an end-to-end neural network to directly generating an upright panoramic image from a non-upright one, and save more time and space for downstream tasks. Before introducing our approach, let's take a brief look at the related research in this field. As Fixan shows, previous image adjustment methods primarily rely on CNN or GCN to estimate tilt angles. The pixel displacement estimation in deep learning typically involves optical flow estimation for moving cameras and disparate estimation for stereo images. In this work, we depart from the conventional tilt angle estimation and instead focus on estimating pixel displacement in panoramic images to achieve image adjustment. We employ an encoder-decoder architecture to accomplish this task. Firstly, in the encoder, a series of downsampling operations are applied to obtain features. Subsequently, a feature fusion operation is utilized to derive the inclination features, also known as motion features. In the decoder, the inclination features pass through a feature upsampling module to estimate pixel displacement. The obtained pixel displacement is then mapped with the non-upright image to generate the corrected upright image. And we use LE loss and perceptual loss to regularize our network. To obtain the inclination features, we start by applying average pooling to the features to capture the global information of the image. Subsequently, a linear layer is used to fuse these features to express the tilt in different directions and align with the pixel displacement channels. We reshape the features to obtain the final inclination features. This process allows us to effectively represent the tilt in various directions caused by the camera's inclination. We conducted ablation experiments on the convolutional layers in the network, the perceptual loss, and the coefficients. The experimental results indicate that the network achieves the best performance when employing a dual layer convolution, utilizing perceptual loss with a coefficient of 0.1. Additionally, to evaluate the results of the image adjustment, we employed normalized root mean squared error and normalized mean absolute error. We individually rotated the panoramic images by 1 and 2 degrees in both the pitch and roll directions and calculated the NRMSE and the NMAE between the related images and the original images. Subsequently, we computed the NRMSE and NMAE between our method generated images and the original images. The results indicate that our method achieves adjustment accuracy within the range of 1 and 2 degrees. Furthermore, we assessed the generated images for image quality, inference time, and occupied space. Our method outperformed the traditional approaches in terms of these evaluation metrics. Moreover, we showcased the overall effectiveness of the generated upright adjustment images, and our results demonstrated superior performance. We further tested the effectiveness of our method by applying the adjusted results to subsequent tasks on panoramic images, such as pedestrian detection and depth estimation. The experimental results indicate that our method is beneficial for downstream research tasks as well. Thank you for your attention, and I would be happy to answer any question you may have regarding our research.